is Bridget. I witnessed a murder.
Just get up on the stand and tell the judge what you saw,
and we'll protect you.
You don't get it. Bottaway wants me dead. I'm dead. I ran to my sister, Siobhan, for help.
Siobhan! Siobhan!
Siobhan killed herself, and I assumed her identity.
It was so easy. I saw a way out, and I took it. They all think that I'm her.
Her husband. Her best friend. Her lover.
Tell me what you did to my wife.
The only person I could trust.
Something's not right here.
Charlie has another address. I need to check it out.
Okay, Gemma, you're not gonna make a peep.
Charlie, you've gone above and beyond the call of duty of a sponsor. I'm just trying to figure out why.
Just a good guy, I guess.
Siobhan, she's on to me.
Hey, you okay?
Yeah, you?
Okay, just a little freaked out. Did you find the gun?
No, I searched most of Charlie's apartment. I got out of there after you texted. But I found something else. Charlie's cell.
Thing's dead, though. Too late to get a charger tonight.
I'll pick one up in the morning. Hopefully, we'll get some answers then.
Okay.
I'll call you in the morning.
Andrew?
I'm in here.
Not overkill, is it? I know white roses are your favorite.
It's amazing. What did I do to deserve this?
Well, I know it's not until tomorrow, but I wanted to say happy anniversary.
Thank you.
Could you believe it's been 6 years? Feels like.
6 weeks.
I made reservations at Daniel for 8:30 tomorrow. He'll give you a real gift then.
Real gift? Wait, there's more.
Trust me, you're gonna love it.
I don't have anything for you.
I have everything I need.
I love you.
I love you too. It's been a while since we've said that. Feels pretty good, huh?
Send him up.
Big sister's watching you.
I'm sorry, what'd you say?
It was a joke. Like Big Brother.
Well, have a good day at school.
Hey.
Hi.
Hi.
Andrew?
He's getting ready for work.
Finally got it charged.
Charlie's phone?
It's not Charlie's.
But that's Gemma's. Charlie.
Carly has Gemma? Give me 5 minutes, please. Andrew found out that I was in Paris. I slipped up and I used my credit card. He asked me to come back. He wanted to work things out.
So the second I leave, you sneak off?
We've been together 6 years. I have a stepdaughter. I had to at least try. I thought you were going to be in Rome. I had no idea you would be in New York.
What do you want, Siobhan? I know you didn't fly back just to say you're sorry.
Andrew and I didn't exactly work things out.
My God.
I know.
He hit you?
Andrew puts on a good face, but he's not the man that you think he is. I'm sorry for lying to you. My husband is an incredibly powerful man. He was never going to let me just walk away. I had to do something. You have insider information. I needed your help.
So you targeted me because Andrew was my boss? Asked me to do something illegal that could have destroyed my career?
I know. And I can't even begin to tell you how sorry I am.
And I can't believe that you pretended to like me just to get back at your husband.
I did. At first. But then something happened. I started to have feelings for you. The other stuff doesn't matter anymore. I came back to Paris for you.
You may want to put some ice on that.
Was padlocked. Why would you do that if you weren't trying to hide something?
I don't know. A lot of people lock their basements. If Charlie is behind the hit on Siobhan, what's the reasoning behind taking Gemma?
Maybe he's trying to hurt everyone around her. I don't know. Where are you going?
To Charlie's.
You're not going there. I already broke in there once. We gotta call the cops.
And tell them what? That you broke into his house to steal an already stolen gun. Oh, and by the way, you found a missing woman's cell phone.
I'm not saying tell them the whole truth. Just make them suspicious enough to search his place. Make Charlie open that door. If your friend's life is on the line...
Shiv?
Malcolm, pleasant surprise. What are you doing here?
Just wanted to stop by and say thank you again.
That's not necessary. Just glad to see you doing well. Well, I'm off to work. Can't wait for tonight. Happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary.
Anniversary.
6 years already. Can you believe it? I'm gonna go call the cops.
You John Delario?
Yeah, I'm John Delario. Why?
NYPD. Got some questions. I'm Detective Towers. This is Detective Saldana.
Elizabeth Saldana?
Yeah.
You work with a buddy of mine, Steve Norman.
How do you know Steve?
He was my partner for 5 years.
You went NYPD?
I'm retired. So what can I do for you guys?
Well, we're investigating a lead in a missing persons case. You ever hear of Gemma Butler?
The architect? Yeah, I read about her in the paper.
Do you know Malcolm Ward?
Yeah, from N.A.
He's been making some allegations. Claims you've been misrepresenting yourself, that you call yourself Charlie Young?
I do. and group. I don't like using my real name. It's called Narcotics Anonymous.
Mr. Ward also says you have a fake apartment.
Wow, you know, this guy needed a place to stay, so I put him up in my apartment, and I come here to my mother's old place. She recently passed.
Does this look familiar?
Look, Elizabeth, they all look alike to me.
This belongs to Gemma Butler. Mr. Ward claims he found it at your place.
Look, guys, I know you're just doing your job, but Malcolm Ward, he's a drug addict. He's been clean for, what, 6 days? I wouldn't take his word as gospel. Now, that said, I got nothing to hide. Come on in.
Sorry about the trouble.
All good.
Mr. DeLario claims he's never seen the cell phone or Gemma Butler.
And you believe him?
His place came up clean. We're running prints on the phone, but right now there's no proof. And it's your word against his.
Would you mind coming down to the station with us?
What for?
You think Malcolm is involved in this?
I don't think anything, Mrs. Martin. But let me tell you what I know. Malcolm Ward, the sponsor of Bridget Kelly, who right now is the main suspect in Gemma Butler's disappearance, is somehow in possession of the victim's cell phone.
I told you I found it in Charlie's apartment.
We spoke to Mr. DeLario's neighbor. She saw a man who fits your description breaking into Mr. DeLario's second residence last night. The same residence you allege you've never been to.
Let's get this over with.
Well, then I'm going.
You've already been questioned, Mrs. Martin. It's not necessary.
Well, I don't really care if you...
Siobhan, please. Just give us a second. Charlie's a smart guy. If Jim wasn't in the basement, then he must have moved her. He's also an ex-cop, so no matter what I say, they're gonna believe him over an ex-junkie, and he knows it. Just let me answer their questions. I got nothing to hide.
Fine.
Siobhan, I knew your friggin' sister knew something. I just didn't know how much.
Calm down, John.
Don't tell me to calm down! She knows my real name. She knows where I live. And her dick friend stole the friggin' cell phone. They know I got Gemma.
Where is she?
I moved her before the cops got here. If I didn't realize that someone had been in my house, she'd still be in the basement, and I'd be in jail.
Well, what do you want to do?
You know, Gemma knows too much. I think it's time we got rid of her.
No. No way. You're just supposed to keep her quiet. That's the plan.
Plan changed.
John, if you hurt her, I swear...
Oh, well, would you just spare me? I think it's a little late to pretend that you still give a damn about her.
She's my friend.
Yeah? I'd hate to see how you treat your enemies.
Okay, John, look, there's no reason for us to argue. I need you. I know that. What do you want?
Double what you promised me.
Fine. But it's gonna take me a little bit of time to access that kind of money.
Yeah, all right. Well, if I'm gonna do this pro bono, we're gonna do this my way.
John, please.
Nope. Sorry, Siobhan. Game over. No longer get a say.
John!
Hey. Heard you in town. Welcome back to Wyoming.
Great to be back. You got a rundown on the victim?
Mary Curtis. Rock Springs local, mother of one dancer, club caged.
Bridget's not the only answer to locking up Bottaway. Thanks to you.
Don't sweet talk a sweet talker, Vic. No, I'm just a blabbermouth stripper. Let's not pretend I'm anything else.
No, no, you're my informant, and I don't take that lightly.
Sure, Bonaway's got an airtight alibi.
Mary was last seen pulling into the motel parking lot early this morning.
Anyone in your department that you're not 100% on?
Detective Haynes is a Red Sox fan, but I'm not going to hold that against him. Heck, they're all stand-up guys, as far as I can tell. Why?
I knew her. She was my CI.
By the way, say anything else about this guy on the inside?
No. Just keeps calling him the Matador.
Ever see him or hear him?
No. Everything happens in the basement of the club. No girls allowed. Hey, Vic.
Yeah.
If you find Bridget, tell her I miss her.
A few weeks ago, she told me that Bonaway's got a man inside your department.
What? Hold on. We've been working the McCowie case together, what, for 2 years? And all that time, you never thought to mention he had an informant for your tits?
No, no. Mary Curtis wasn't my CI the whole time. Shailene Briggs was, until Bonaway killed her. I just started working with Mary. I gave her my word that I'd keep her a secret, even from my colleagues.
I'm sorry, man. This has got to be rough for you.
The inside man must have been following Mary. She told me Bonaway's nickname for him.
What's the name?
Matador. Does that mean anything to you?
No. I'll sniff around.
Just careful, okay? Last thing I need is another body.
What do you mean that Charlie took Gemma? I thought he was supposed to be helping us. I mean, you said that this guy could be trusted.
I was wrong.
Does Charlie have something to do with your sister?
No.
But he knows you.
Yes, but I...
Okay, why do all roads lead back to Siobhan Martin?
How many times are we gonna do this? I had nothing to do with Gemma's disappearance.
And yet the only suspects are your twin and a guy that you brought into our lives.
I didn't come here to play the blame game, okay? I came for help. Malcolm thinks that Gemma was in Charlie's basement, but he must have moved her.
Who the hell is Malcolm?
He's a friend of mine.
Another friend helping out? That's awesome, Siobhan. That's awesome. So what is he going to turn out to be? A mob boss? A serial killer? Al-Qaeda?
I'm just trying to find Gemma.
You don't think that I want that, too? I have not slept in weeks. My kids miss their mom like crazy. All I want is for Gemma to come home.
Okay, then help me find...
Stop! Don't you get it? Every time that you get involved, it just makes matters worse. You are not a cop. So stay out of it, Siobhan. Let the police do their job.
Separating trash from recycling. If you're not sure if something's recyclable, look for the chasing arrow symbol on the bottom.
Thanks for being here, Tessa.
See, I don't have a choice. It's called detention.
Well, the planet still thanks you.
Mr. C is so hot.
Ew, he wears ties and is like a thousand.
Ties are sexy and he's only 30. Besides...
Guys, there's trash everywhere here. Let's go, huh?
Bella married Edward when she was a teenager and he's like 400.
No, that's
right. Hey. Thanks. Thank you. Thanks. I'm so psyched to go green.
And I appreciate the enthusiasm.
Wow. Yeah, he like hates you.
No, he doesn't. He's just playing it cool. We totally have a connection.
True. I mean, what can you do about it? I mean, please. It's all my own fault, of course.
Siobhan, you remember Charlie Young, Malcolm's sponsor?
Hey, it's been a while.
Charlie wanted to stop by and give us an update on Malcolm. Isn't that nice?
Very.
Look, I don't want to be rude, but I have to run a couple of errands before tonight.
You're leaving me?
Trust me, you're going to want me to run these errands. It's our anniversary.
It's your anniversary? Ah, well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, don't worry, Mrs. Martin. I'm not going to keep you here that long.
A pleasure. See you later, darling.
Sit your ass down.
You try anything, I'll have cops swarming this place in 30 seconds.
Don't relax. I'm not here to hurt you.
You could have fooled me.
Whatever it is you think you know, you don't.
I know you took Gemma. Just tell me she's okay.
She's okay.
Why did you take her? What do you want from me?
This is not 20 questions, Siobhan. I'm not here for your edification.
And what do you want?
I want money.
That's what this is about? Money?
It's real simple. You pay me, and I give you back your friend.
How do I know I can trust you?
You don't. But what choice do you have?
Hiya, Max.
Hey, Mr. Butler.
How you doing today?
Yeah, pretty good.
Did Charlie Young visit the Martins?
Who's just here?
Is he the guy that just left?
I said I didn't want anything for our anniversary, but I'd be a fool to turn away cold, hard cash. What's this?
Shiv, what's wrong?
I know where Gemma is.
What are you gonna tell me, Shiv?
Oh, I wanted to, but Charlie said if I told anyone that I'm supposed to meet him at Penn Station at 10. What are you doing?
I'm calling the cops.
Well, you can't.
You're being blackmailed. We're calling Detective Saldana.
Look, Charlie said we can't tell anyone, okay? We can't take that risk. Malcolm already tried calling the cops, and it backfired. Oh, please, it's a very public place. Charlie is not stupid. He's not gonna try anything. Will you please just trust me?
Okay, fine. But you're not going alone.
I don't have a choice.
Neither do I. I'm not letting my wife go toe-to-toe with a psychopath. I'm going with you.
Okay.
How much does he want?
$250,000.
I mean, without even counting, I know that's not enough.
Almost 40. It's from my savings.
I wish you'd have told me sooner, Shiv. I could have gotten the rest, but the bank's now closed. Have you called Henry?
For the money?
No. He doesn't have that sort of money lying around. No, just to tell him. I mean, it is his wife.
I was afraid he would tell his in-laws and then...
The police get involved.
I'm out of ideas.
This was your real gift.
My God, it's stunning.
I was gonna propose again, know it's silly.
No, it's not silly.
The ring is worth well over 200,000.
Thanks for the saw, Mr. C.
Well, thanks for helping out.
Who'd have ever thought picking up trash would be this exhausting?
Yeah, it's hard work. Gives you an appreciation for what our custodians do every day.
Yeah, I guess. So, what are you doing tonight?
Cleaning up and grading papers. Thank you.
Yeah. I guess I can help. I mean, if you want me to.
Thanks, but you've helped out enough already today.
No, really, it's no bother, really.
Juliet! You need to stop this.
Stop what?
Acting this way. It's inappropriate.
I don't know what you're talking
this
about.
This kind of behavior is unacceptable, and it won't be tolerated.
If you think I'm flirting with you, stop flattering yourself. I'm just trying to be nice. Hey, Andrea, let's get out of here.
Andrea, please wait in the hall. I'd like to finish my conversation with Miss Martin without the theatrics.
What the hell are we doing out here?
I got something for you.
Officer Jesse Province. He's got a cousin who worked the door at Bottaway's club. And a brand new speedboat he'd like to take out to Glendale Reservoir on the weekends.
How do you think he bought it with dirty money?
Well, I was ashore, so I followed him after he clocked out tonight. He came straight here.
Seems like a nice little spot for a rendezvous with Bottaway.
Any idea why Bottaway would call him Matador?
Not a one. But if we find them together, maybe we can ask.
Andrew wouldn't let me.
I'm not talking about London Fog. I'm talking about the cops.
I didn't call the cops.
Look out the window. Somebody did.
It wasn't me.
Doesn't matter because they're there.
Please, you just give me a second chance, please. Just tell me where I can meet you.
It's too late.
Wait, no, but I have what you want. Just tell me how I can get it to you.
Are you crazy?
The cops are following you. I'm not taking any more chances.
Charlie, I'm begging you.
Sorry, Siobhan. My goodwill's all maxed out. Sunshine. I didn't want to do this. But your bitch friend screwed up.
He's not coming. Somebody called the cops.
What?
Thank you. guys doing here?
I've been following you since late afternoon.
Why? I stopped by your place earlier. I saw Charlie Young coming out.
You still think I'm involved in this?
I don't know what to think, so I freaked out and I called the cops.
I would never hurt Gemma. Why didn't you just talk to me?
Because I am done talking. Siobhan, Gemma's life is at stake.
Charlie came to me and asked for a ransom. That's why we're here. To get her back.
Well, then where the hell is he?
He sold the detective's car and ran.
Forensics came back on Gemma's phone. Delario's prints were all over it. Detective Towers has dispatched cars to both of his residences, but he's not at either place.
We need to find out more about this guy. There might be something here.
Why don't you check here? It's a build for a storage facility. Maybe this is where he has Gemma.
Two years that you and I have been after Badawi Makawi. Would you believe I didn't like you when I first met you?
The feeling was mutual.
Oh, thanks. But then I did a little homework, and I found out that you'd taken down scum like Badawi before.
My old buddy Silas Turnbull.
That's right, yeah. Big guy. Right? Made his living smuggling underage sex slaves into Wyoming. You went after him with a warrant, but he charged at you. Well, 263 pounds of him, but you just dropped him with a single shot. He had a nickname. Something his buddies used to call him.
Bull.
Right, because Turnbull. And the size thing. Well, that's funny. You know what they call guys who put down bulls? Matadors.
Thought you'd figure it out eventually.
No, Officer Providence, is there? It's just you and me, right? Maybe a shovel to dig a hole.
Sorry, Vic. I didn't want it to come to this.
Oh, no, it won't. I've had two agents tailing me ever since you and I spoke this morning.
You're bluffing.
Questions to answer. Starting with what really happened the night that Bridget Kelly ran.
Hey.
Hey. I just wanted to make sure you're okay.
I'm fine.
That was convincing. What happened earlier, after I left you with Mr. C? Are you okay?
I said I didn't want to talk about it.
It might make you feel better.
I doubt it.
Oh, come on, Juliet. Look, I won't tell anyone. I promise.
I doubt that.
I swear to God.
We had sex.
You had sex with Mr. Carpenter?
But I didn't want to.
Yeah, you did. I mean, you were totally throwing yourself at him.
No, you don't understand. He forced himself on me.
How are you even alive?
You
got bad aim.
Siobhan.
You mean Bridget?
I mean Siobhan. That bitch is still alive.
Siobhan?
Give me your weapon. I told you not to kill Gemma.
Yeah, well, I told you if I'm taking all the risks, we're gonna do it my way.
Not anymore.
You're not a killer, Siobhan. Otherwise, you would have put a bullet right in Bridget's head. Which, by the way, would have been a hell of a lot easier than getting her to take the fall for you, so don't point that gun at me! Besides, you said so yourself. You need me.
I don't. You're a glorified babysitter who got way too expensive.
Okay.
Thanks for letting me spend the night. Again?
It's not a problem. Please tell me the police apologized when they released you.
They asked me if I needed a ride home. That's about it.
Maybe you should go to bed.
You can't. If anything happens to Jonah.
Hey, listen to me. None of this is your fault. Hello? I see. Okay, thank you, Detective Saldana. They found Charlie's body. They think he killed himself.
Gemma?
I'm so sorry, Chef.
Hello?
It's me. Where are you?
New York. I'm going to have to stay here for a while.
Figured as much. Did I wake you?
No. I haven't really been able to sleep.
Me neither. I went to settle your tab at the hotel. They said you left some stuff in a drawer. Siobhan,
Are you pregnant?
Yes.
This is mine?
Yes.
You okay?
No. But I will be.
One more look around. Make sure we got everything. This is the last time I ever want to see Charlie's apartment. What's that?
I don't know.
That's Charlie's handwriting. That's Pivoin.
I thought with Charlie gone, I would stop asking questions. But I can't. Why was he after Siobhan? Why Gemma? This can't just be about money. There has to be more to it. She is a stranger. You and I have history, or don't you remember?